Kai guys, American, in this opportunity I'm gonna talk about the letters of the Congress of Chile. The Congress of Chile is a very, very, very important event for our country because from the past, we can explain the present. Before in high school in Chile, colonial literature was taught, but not today. We only study La Araucana and some fragments of Columbus' travel diary. In the travel diary, Columbus believed that he has seen mermaids. Pedro de Valdivia was a Spanish conqueror, like the other, for example, Hernán Cortés, Francisco Pizarro, Diego Almagro. In his time, Valdivia was a famous captain. Famous like other current characters. Pedro de Valdivia wrote 12 letters between 1541 and 1553, or only 12 have been found. Where are the letters? Maybe along with the other less historical things. He was appointed captain very young and married in Spain, but some decide to come to America.
Mi amor, voy y vuelvo.
One eternity later.
According to the history, Valdivia came to our continent in 1555. And after a few years, he obtained permission to start the conquest of Chile. Chile was viewed negatively for the people during this time.
I am your father.
No!
With few resources, he decided to travel to Chile. In Chile, he founded cities. He survives the indigenous attacks and even go to participate in a war in Peru against Gonzalo Pizarro. Valdivia died in Tucapel in December 1553, and that is the end of our conqueror. In this letter, some narrative matrices appear, which are repeated over and over and over.
2 hours later.
And over again. For example, letter 1, 2, and 3 refers to the death of Francisco Pizarro. Letter 2, 3, 5, 9 refer to the Santiago fire. Letter 7, 8, 9, and 10 refer to the defeat of Gonzalo Pizarro in Peru. And so many topics which are constantly repeated. These topics are a matrix, so I wonder why Valdivia repeat these topics over and over and over.
2 hours later.
And over again. My hypothesis is that this letter allowed Valdivia to build a positive idea about the conquest of Chile.
La conquista de Chile va bien, ¿cierto?
Obvio, 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 obvio.
And in all letters appears an element in common, the coloniality of power. Coloniality of power is an expression used to name the structure of power, control, and hegemony that have emerged during the modernist time. The objective of my research is to reveal the coloniality of power in this letter from the narrative matrices. What do you think more interesting about this topic? Leave your opinion in the comments and like this video if you also love Pedro de Valdivia.